Hey guys, welcome back to another PC build suggestion video. Been a long time since I have done a build suggestion video on this channel, but these are tough times and not everyone has the means to get and go out and spend hundreds of dollars or thousands of rupees on PCs currently. So I thought, why not do something different this time? I'm here with another PC build guide for you people, but this time I'm going to suggest you the best PC parts in the second hand market. So we are going to avoid any new or current gen products, and the suggestions will be completely based on general pricing of the second hand items. Now, second hand market can be a bit finicky and there are no set rules in this market. It's kind of like the wild west of PC gaming. People generally are afraid of getting scammed or overpaying for a certain product in this second hand market. But if you know how much you should be paying for a particular product and what is the current market price of that, there is hardly any chance of getting scammed. Also, make sure you buy the products that are under warranty, as that gives you another layer of protection against any damage once you have already bought it. Today I am going to be doing a solid mid-range second-hand build within 40,000 rupees or around $500, which can easily play all latest and greatest AAA games at 1080p ultra settings at smooth 60 frames per second without a worry in the world, and even at 1440p medium to high settings with close to 50 frames per second. Please leave a like on this video if you have liked it and subscribe to my channel. With that said, let's move on to the suggestions. Starting our list off with the CPU. At this point in time, the best mid-range second-hand gaming CPU is Ryzen 5 2600. In the second-hand market, you can get this CPU for as low as $80 to $90 or 8,000 Indian rupees, which is an absolute bargain bin for this 6-core 12-thread CPU in 2020. This is the best choice for anyone looking to build a solid mid to high range gaming PC. If you want to game, create videos and stream but not put a hole in your bank account, then Ryzen 5 2600 is the best mid range CPU you can buy right now in the used market. For motherboard, we are going to go with practically any B450 Micro ATX motherboards. You can get hold of high quality MSI B450 motherboards for around 4000 rupees or 50 to 60 US dollars. The brand also does not quite matter in mid-range PC builds as long as the motherboard is in the mid-range of the spectrum. Do not go for any B350 or A320 motherboards, which even though can run second-range Ryzen technically, would not recommend them for future upgrade purposes. So for motherboard, get hold of a good MSI, Gigabyte or ASUS B450 board and you are good to go. We now move on to the RAM. RAM prices has come down significantly in the last year. I still remember buying my 16GB RAM kit for 12,000 rupees or around $150. It still hurts, man. And now a 16GB kit, even new, costs less than half of that. So you can easily get a good 2666 or 3000 MHz kit secondhand for around 4000 rupees max or around $50 to $60. And with RGB too. You don't have to think much about RAM as any good branded RAMs would work just fine. Just make sure to buy them in dual channel kits, otherwise the performance of your entire system will suffer significantly. So if you are planning to get 16GB of RAM, then buy 2 sticks of 8GB each. Same for 8GB, go for 2 sticks of 4 each and so on. This brings us to the most important part of a gaming machine, the graphics card. No matter how good your CPU or RAM is, graphics card is the single most important factor when it comes to performance in gaming. For graphics card, we will be picking up the card I am currently using in my machine, the GTX 1070 Mini from Zotac. When this card was launched back in 2016, it costed around $400 or almost 35,000 rupees and provided excellent 1440p performance. Now this card can be picked up for as low as 14,000 rupees or $170, which is an exceptional price for the kind of performance it provides. Today, in 2020, this card is an exceptional 1080p gaming card with no compromises. You can expect well over 60fps in most AAA games at ultra settings at 1080p with this card. You can also crank up the resolution to 1440p and still get close to 60 frames per second at medium to high details in the most modern AAA games. If you are going secondhand, GTX 1070 at this price point is the best graphics card you can choose. Next, we come to the heart of our machine, the PSU. And as I have always said in all my videos, Never ever skimp on a PSU. This is the single biggest mistake you can make while building a gaming PC. You certainly would not want to blow up your entire system for saving a few couple of bucks. Keeping that in mind, we will go with good branded like Corsair, Cooler Master or Seasonic brands for picking up our PSU. While looking for the PSU in the second-hand market, make sure to check its rating. At least get PSUs with 80 plus bronze rated efficiency. For the kind of system we are building, a 550 watt PSU will be perfect for our build. However, if you can, try to purchase the PSU new, as that cuts the risk of PSU failure significantly. If you are buying new, go for Corsair CX650 or CX550 PSU, and you won't have to worry a bit about the power consumption requirements in your system. And this brings us to storage. For storage, I will suggest a minimum of 240 GB of SSD, as we can afford that in our budget, and with that, a 1 TB of mechanical hard drive at least. In India, we are still a little bit apprehensive about using SSDs, as we fail to see the value because practically it provides no gaming benefit. But believe me, your PC will feel 1,000 times faster and more responsive with an SSD installed in it. It will be much more snappier, and you can really feel that you have built a new gaming PC. And moreover, the price of SSDs has come down significantly in the last couple of years, and the inclusion of one is completely justified in our budget. You can get a second-hand 240 GB SSD for around 1500 rupees and a 1 TB mechanical hard drive for around the same price. So for storage, you can have pretty beefy storage solution for around 3000 rupees or $50. Lastly, we come to the cabinet. The choice of cabinet is a very subjective one. What looks good and appealing to me may be looking awful to you. Or you can say that you don't want a transparent side panel, or you would want a tempered glass panel only. Also, finding a cabinet in the second-hand market can be a bit tricky, as people do not sell their cabinets as often as they do for other parts. Having said that, you can get hold of a good ATX cabinet within 2500 to 3000 rupees or $440 that will perform excellently in terms of cooling as well as provide ample room for future upgrades. You can look for Corsair or NZXT brands while choosing cabinets in this price range. So guys, that was my suggestion for building a tremendous 1440p gaming PC using only used parts within a budget of only 40,000 rupees or $500. I believe this is the best value you can get if you are ready to spend that much amount on a gaming rig. Now that we are done with our build, let's find out what spending this amount can bring actually in terms of performance. So let's move on to some real-time benchmarks.
Get that train moving.
Thank you.
fine looking nag there, you know.
Hi there, mister.
Cut through. Okay, let's go. Let's see what we're dealing with. Ah, there they are.
How do you want to do this? I'll take care of this one.
So as we can clearly see, guys, in the benchmarks, this PC is no joke, and it's extremely capable to run all modern AAA games at 1080p ultra settings at more than 60 frames per second, at 1440p high settings at close to 60 fps. Obviously at 4K we will need some more powerful card like the GTX 1080 or the 1080 Ti, but 4K adoption is still not into mainstream and it's very expensive in my opinion, and most of us still play our favorite games at 1080p or 1440p resolution. So for this use case, this PC is a killer machine that can blaze through all AAA games you throw at it. So thanks for watching this video, guys. I hope you have really liked the video and found the suggestions useful. Please let me know in the comments below any video ideas or other price points you would want to see the same for. I will definitely make those videos. Please like this video if you have liked it, subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon to never miss an update on future videos. Keep gaming, keep slaying, stay safe, stay at home. Peace out.